This shot is a motion-controlled shot with a difference mat, which is a technique I always liked using. Got it from my experience in film restoration. It took about a day and a half to shoot. This montage shows something I like doing in my digital effects work in film. If I'm doing my job right, nobody knows that there's any digital effects within a shot. The shot just reads as it would normally and nothing stands out. In this case, we have several motion-controlled camera work shots, like here with the pierogies, with some digital smoke on top of them. The same is true with the refrigerator coming up. Multiple passes with a motion-controlled camera, compositions, digital smoke on top of it. And if everything works well, it just fits into the movie, implying how hungry Sarah is. I always loved this gag. I remember when I proposed it, having the soundtrack actually modulate the image, using the sound wave itself, averaging it out, and then putting that against some variable that varies how far an image jumps back and forth. The gag involved a lot of rotoscoping, drawing around the outside of the bits of flying food. Plus composition. We're using Chalice, After Effects, and Inferno, which is a very high-end product by Discrete Logic for compositing. The Inferno did this shot. This shot was literally hundreds of gigabytes of data. It doesn't read digital at all, I believe, but there's a lot more going on than meets the eye. There's a line that goes in between Sarah and the doctor, so they can travel at different speeds, and then has to be averaged out. There has to be degraining and regraining. It's important to remember that all the shots in this film are handled as 2,000 pixel across scanned image data. Each file is about 8 megabytes per frame. So, something I always say is about 40% of any effects job is data management. And I think that's true literally with any sort of artwork involving computers. This was the longest shot to post-produce. There was rotoscoping and Chalice drawing around the characters. So we could put something else inside their image area. It took about 3.5 months. One and two operators working 10 to 15 hours a day. The original script direction when I got it was Red Sarah Leaves the Television. I originally had the idea of actually getting the video tap off of the camera on the set, but they weren't able to do that, so then we took the footage, transferred it to VHS video, really trashed up some more, transferred it back, blew it back up, and put it inside the mats.
Our next winner is that delightful personnel. Straight.
It's the end shot. It's more video to film work.
To Mrs. Sarah Gophar.
I got about 10 different phone calls from producers and directors about making this the best looking video to film transfer ever made. I actually went too far at first. They liked it so much, they thought nobody would realize it was video, so we had to go back and junk up this section in the end a little bit here. Red Sarah and her son's combined fantasy. That caps the film. It's kind of stunning when I think about it that the film sort of has a happy ending in there. You know, group hallucination. They get to say they love each other in this beautiful TV world.